Salutations. I'm Jesco, and you're watching Game Dev Made Easy.
This is the final video that I will have made while living in China.
In the video today,
we are going to work with DragonRuby. DragonRuby is a game engine made using the Ruby programming language. Now hear me out. DragonRuby takes the minimalist approach to game development and does not rely on heavy usage of magic variables or methods that is usually present with the Ruby programming language. So, you can get DragonRuby on itch.io, or if you are like me and found it on Reddit, the links are in the description below. There are some pros and cons to the engine. Pros are that it is very easy to pick up and go with on any operating system. Loads of sample games and explanations, a beginner and intermediate primer for the Ruby language itself in the samples, and does not require Ruby to be installed on your machine to work with the engine. The cons are no IntelliSense for the built-in classes and no documentation on the full API for the engine. There is, however, a basic explanation on the DragonRuby itch page, but it doesn't go very in-depth into this. For the video today, we are going to implement a button from the ground up. Before we can actually do that, we really have to understand what a button actually is. A button, in its base form, is a rectangle, a label, and a click event. You can expand upon it by adding an image to it and a mouse event for mouse over and mouse off driving the image as well. So after you have unzipped the DragonRuby or DragonRuby GTK low res folder, go inside the directory a bit further. Go inside the My Game folder. Go inside of the App folder. Double-click to open main.rb in Notepad++ or Visual Studio Code if you are on Windows. For Mac, Atom, IntelliJ, or Visual Studio Code are your options. We are going to delete everything from the main.rb file. A blank slate, if you will. Let's begin by creating a class. Write class button. This is similar to any other object-oriented language where we are defining our class. Directly underneath it, with the tab space, write attr underscore accessor. This is an attribute that allows for us to get and set instance variables. Write colon outputs comma space colon inputs. This allows for us to access the outputs and input methods defined within the engine. As you can probably guess, these handle I/O and rendering. Let's go to a new line and write def display button. We are defining our first method of this class. Now, let's add parameters to it. You can go with two different ways to handle this. The first way is to just write x, y, text, or the second way, which is to add an opening parentheses x, y, text, and a closing parentheses. Both ways are valid in Ruby. I will go with the parentheses approach since I am used to C-style syntax. As you can see, we aren't defining the types for these variables. That is because Ruby is a dynamically typed language, just like Python. The x variable will be our x position, the y variable will be our y position, and the text variable will be our string value. The x and y will automatically be inferred as an integer value unless we use floating point values. Press the enter button, and in the next line, write button underscore border is set to be square bracket x, y, 150, 150, 0, 0, 128, and closing square bracket. This is an array in Ruby, and the values in order by index is as followed: X position, Y position, width, height, red, green, blue. On the next line, write button underscore label is set to open square bracket X plus 50 comma Y plus 75 comma text and closing square bracket. The values for this array is X position, Y position, and the text value. On the next line, write outputs dot borders with two greater than symbols, button underscore border. This is saying that we are taking the output's borders and we want it to get the place where the border is defined, which is the button underscore border, and request the new border to be added from the definition. On a new line, let's do the same thing, but for the label. Write outputs dot labels with two greater than symbols, and then write button underscore label. Now for the tricky part. We are going to be registering our click events. This will require a nested if statement because we need to check for a regular click event, and then we need to check if the click event happens within the border of our button. To do this, we first need to start a new line and then write if inputs.mouse.click. This is just for subscribing to listen for the click event from the mouse. On a new line, write if inputs.mouse.click.point.inside_RECT with the question mark. This if statement is checking if we are clicking inside of the rectangle from the object that is of the type rectangle. The question mark designates that this is nullable. The last thing to do on this line is to write button underscore border. This will make the inside rectangle point to our button border object. On the next line, write outputs dot labels with two greater than symbols. Write open square bracket 200 comma 300 comma open quote clicked closing quote and closing square bracket. This will generate a new label that will tell us if the button was clicked or not. We aren't done here yet. Write end four times. This will be the terminators of the two if statements we created, our display button method, and our class. Ruby is very similar to Python in these regards. Instead of semicolons, we use the word end. Visual Basic is similar to this as well. That concludes the main bulk of this code. As a matter of fact, the implementation details are done. Now we just have to define the tick method for our main method that will call this code, and this will run as we intended to. On a new line, write def tick args. This is our main update loop. The args is just an informal name for arguments, which we will soon make heavy use of. Write $button is set to be button.new. This creates an instance of the button class. The $ designates that this is a global variable. On a new line, write $button.outputs is set to be args.outputs. We are specifying that the attribute underscore accessor, which is called output, is the same as the args outputs. On the next line, write $button.inputs is set to be args.inputs. And again, we are specifying that the attribute underscore accessor, which is called inputs, is the same as the args inputs. The final line is $button.displayButton. The parameters are 500, 400, and the string value of click. We are finally calling that display button method we defined in the button class and setting the variables required for it. Finally, write end, which again designates that this is the end of the method block. There you have it. We can click on the DragonRuby.exe file or the DragonRuby file specific for Mac or Linux. It will run the program, and if you click inside of the button, it will quickly flash the text telling us that this code worked correctly. As a challenge for you guys, go through the samples for DragonRuby and try to figure out how to add images to the display button method, make it so after clicking that the text will stay shown while the button is being pressed, and fix the alignment bug that is present on the text if you use longer text phrases. Thank you all for watching, and I'll see you guys when I return to the USA in the next few days, where I will be able to record more content for you guys and showcase my solution to the challenge asked of you.